In the shadows of the glacier-clad Jaya Wijaya Mountains along the southern coast of West Papua live the Kamoro people.
Tuesday on the island.
The Kamoro people are traditionally coastal fishermen and coconut harvesters. The Kamoro are a friendly people, accepting of others from foreign lands, sometimes as a source of protein, if the fish aren't biting, that is.
For everyone's delight, you can hear them on a coconut telegraph, can't keep nothing under their hat. You can hear them on the coconut telegraph, say yeah, who did this and that, this and that. I'm not one to deal in gossip, but was he that big a fool to do a belly buster high dive and miss the entire pool? And what became of sweet Melissa and the boy nobody knew? Did Ricardo ever find her? I swear it's just between me and you. But you can hear it on the coconut telegraph by now, everybody knows. You can hear it on the coconut telegraph, just who comes and goes, comes and goes, comes and goes.
This is the story of the Kamoro people and their struggles in the new global economy. Indispensable in the economic endeavors of the Kamoro are the dugout canoes they use. In the old days, not particularly held in reverence or nostalgia by the Kamoro, the canoes had to be paddled for endless hours from the estuaries out to sea in order to find coconut trees laden with the fruit on the outlying islands. These days, they use an Evinrude or a Yamaha.
Jump in, and you'll hear those
The work is still hard, though, but on a good day, the coastal jungles provide the bounty that brings the cash into the family home.
Morning, viewers. Here we are at the end of the monitoring access road. We've encountered some native people here who are unloading coconuts from their canoe, and they are also unloading some fish that they had caught this morning. Both of these things they're going to be selling later today. And with me here is Pat Gabriel from TRMP. That's the Tailings River Management Program, and he's going to tell us a few things about what's going on here. First off, Pa Gabriel, what are they doing with these coconuts? Where do they collect them, and then what are they going to do with them after they unload here?
Okay, they collect the coconut from Pasir Hitam, okay, and then they collect together. Looks like this is a family group, so they will send this all to Timika Village. But here they wait for bus and trucks from Timika, and so they can have this to Timika.
That's very interesting. These buses and the trucks that you're speaking of, who supplies that transportation? What is the economics behind that?
As I know that this is supplied by Freeport. So Freeport from community, they supply for bus and trucks for these local people. And then they already make like a schedule, so as I know, it's about twice a week the bus is coming here for pick up their coconuts and fish and all this stuff. And then another day the buses and trucks pick up from another garden they have for.
Okay, so the buses not only pick up the coconuts and the fish that we're seeing here today, but they also pick up from the gardens
you're right.
Okay, question about this. These coconuts, you have one in your hand. You say they came from Pasir Hitam. That's, 10 kilometers away or so.
Yeah.
These coconuts, when they take them to Tamika, about how much money are they getting per coconut?
This about 1,000 rupees only for this one. And then, they have a lot of money for that too. And about the fish, you see that? The barramundi, and we say that muluticus, or, and then the other fish, sembilang, is they selling about, for barramundi, 50,000 rupees. And then muluticus about 5,000, and then sembilang, same price.
How much was that for the barramundi? What are they getting for that?
50,000 rupees.
Wow, they're getting 50,000 rupees for the barramundi. Yeah, that's a big fish. And then 5,000 rupio or so for the muluticus. That's a fish with a mouse like a mouse. It's much easier to say in Indonesian. The muluticus, I'm wondering, as I look at that fish there, it looks like what we would call in English a catfish. Is that correct?
Okay, yeah, that same thing. The catfish, or we call it here muluticus.
Okay, so you can't take the name of this and translate it into Indonesian and then bring it back to English and have the same fish, huh? You'd take catfish, turn it into ikan kucing, and then change it to muluticus, and then back to mouse fish. The mouth of the mouse fish. Okay, there, viewers, I think we have a picture of what's going on here. The coconuts are picked from an island just offshore at Pasir Hitam, and then the fish are collected. Would they be in the estuaries or offshore?
Sure. Yeah. So they just go around, it's all there, so they can put a netting, and then they can catch the fish.
Okay, so most of these fish are caught with a net. I guess a final point is, these people here, you say this is a family group. These are Kamoro people then?
Yeah, of course. They always Kamoro people, and then they're working with a family group. They never use another from another village for that. No. They're always working in family group. Because if they collect money, so they can spend together.
Okay. All right, I think we got a social picture of what's going on as well. This is all very interesting. Thank you, viewers. I think that's all for now.
Tuesday on the island, not much going on. The parties are all over. The end had just passed on. The jungle drums are beating with the tales from late last night. The story's very heating for everyone's delight. You can hear them on a coconut telegraph, can't keep nothing under their hat. You can hear them on the coconut telegraph saying, who did this and that, this and that, this and that. Now I'm not one to deal in gossip, but was he that big a fool to do a belly buster high dive and miss the entire pool? And what became of sweet Melissa and the boy nobody knew? Did Ricardo ever find her? I swear it's just between me and you. But you can hear it on the coconut telegraph by now, everybody knows. You can hear it on the coconut telegraph, just who comes and goes, comes and goes, comes and goes. History, I guess everything's been said. But when the eagle flies on Friday and the bars break out the rum, then the joint begins to jump in and you'll hear those hotlines hum. I put it on the coconut telegraph,